The Situation Room with Wolf Blitzer, weekdays 4 Eastern.
As the healthcare debate rages on in Washington, we decided to get outside the Beltway. We're heading to Philadelphia to take a look at one alternative people are turning to.
Aren't there that?
It's called bill sharing. In this case, a large group of Christians pool their money to cover each other's medical costs. It's not conventional insurance and it's not regulated. Christian activist Shane Claiborne is a member of one, Ohio-based Christian Healthcare Ministries.
One of the things I like about it is it's relational, and I can see exactly where my money's going. And I also wanted my money not to go to line some executive's pockets or buy yachts and Bentleys, but actually to go directly to meet the medical needs of folks that are really carrying those burdens.
Last time we saw Claiborne, he was touring the country promoting his book, Jesus for President. He moved into this rough Philadelphia neighborhood to help clean it up, like this former drug den he took us to.
We talk a lot about practicing resurrection. So for us, this is a part of it. We bring abandoned spaces to life and try to make ugly things beautiful.
It is rough work. Claiborne was jumped a few years ago, landed in the hospital with a concussion and broken jaw. That's when his health care stepped in.
So you get this bill for $10,000 or $12,000, and then we ended up paying like $6,000 of it. And because I had, you know, thousands and thousands of people carrying that bill with me, I was able to just write, you know, that we just wrote a check for it.
The ministry negotiated directly with his doctors to lower the bill. Executive Director Howard Russell says the core of their success is the 20,000 members who've met conditions that include not smoking, being a Christian, and living by the Bible.
If everybody in America had the provisions that our members have, there wouldn't be a health care crisis.
It's like a health care cooperative, a community-based nonprofit organization owned by its members, a group that uses its strength in numbers to negotiate competitive rates with health care providers. And that's an idea gaining traction on Capitol Hill.
Robert Burns, a professor of healthcare management at the University of Pennsylvania, says the key to co-ops is size, 20 to 50,000 enrollees minimum needed.
If they're not big enough, then they won't be able to do either of those two things, hold down their administrative costs internally or negotiate good rates with the providers externally.
And even then, it may not be enough.
Do you see healthcare co-ops as the silver bullet to this debate?
No, as I told my class last night, it's part of the silver buckshot.
So one of many that needs to be done for reform.
That's right.
Claiborne agrees. His co-op may not suit everyone's health care needs, but he's hoping it at least forces Americans to think outside the box.
I'm not here to endorse one particular project of this, but actually the vision of caring for each other in a way that we're able to provide health care for one another.